I have a question for you. Here I have a glass and some unknown bacteria in this syringe. Let's say I put just one drop in this glass at 11 a.m. Now bacteria grow by doubling themselves. So their population doubles every time they split. Let's say they double every minute. And we also observe that by 12 noon, this glass is 100% full. So the conditions are, we start with one at 11 a.m., they double every minute, and by 12 noon, this glass is 100% full. Now the question, when was the glass half full? And if you were one of the bacteria in this glass, when would you realize that you have a problem? Now come to think about it, our problems, aren't they much the same? Whether we are talking about climate change, whether we are talking about coronavirus, rising population, inflation, so on. They all start slowly, but then increase rapidly. And this is how exponential change works. But most importantly, none of them is predictable after they go out of control. And this is where true innovation plays a very important role, especially when we want to solve a problem. I have been quite fortunate to have a fairly strong technical background. I have seen various technologies up close and personal. And with that experience, I can tell you with a quite confidence that tech solutions may be good, but they are never good enough. So we have to find different ways to solve our modern world problems. Let me explain. Let's look at our bacteria friends here and their exponential growth problem. How would you solve it? Now, most people think that finding another glass is the best course of action. Sure, let's say our bacteria find another glass. And not just one, but three empty glasses. What do you think? Problem solved? Here is what would happen now. We already know that the first glass was half full at 11:59 and at 12, it is 100% full. At 12:01, they double. So 200% population has two glasses full. At 12:02, they double again and that becomes 400 population. Means all glasses are now full. And now they have nowhere to go. Much like this situation, we cannot keep doing things the same way as we did before. We have to think differently. We have to take a new perspective. So here comes another problem. How can we think differently if we rely only on problem-related information? Because if we really want to positively impact and build sustainable outcomes, we need transformative innovation. And it is possible with one key thing. A deep understanding of problems and intents. Then, how do we get that deeper understanding? And it won't be possible if we stay disconnected from ground reality. Most importantly, people. People who are fellow citizens, people who are customers, people who are clients, colleagues, or our associates. I vividly remember my time when I was working with a big telco company. As a consultant, a general manager from one of the business verticals had a problem for me to solve. And it was quite an interesting problem. He said that one of the services in his business is experiencing a significant rise in complaints. And to deal with that situation, they needed to build more capacity. More capacity to respond to those complaints. He was also keen to explore automation, some technological solution to help with that. And I said this before, technology can be good, but not good enough. The head of that business completely missed out on one important thing. Only if they understood why problems existed in the first place. Only if they understood why so many customers were complaining. They could have chosen to connect with customers at a deeper level. They could have chosen to understand customer intents and fix their service. Well, eventually common sense prevailed and my persuasion efforts paid off. We understood root causes and we could eliminate most of them permanently The ones we couldn't, we took preemptive measures. And the result was reduced complaints. Innovation, particularly transformative innovation, it not only fixes the problem, it solves it. It eliminates the root cause. Transformative innovation is not solution focus, it is intent focus. And this may sound counterintuitive, it is. But if you don't understand people's intents better, how could you possibly help them in the true sense? Now, the obvious question you might be asking, what can I do here? How can I help make the world around me a better place for everyone? So, for starters, you can do something today or this week. Try to find at least 5 products, services, or organizations that are working towards eliminating problems instead of just alleviating them. Learn more about them. See why they were able to do which others couldn't. See if you can point out some transformative qualities in them. Secondly, once you have done the first thing and gathered some insights, start evaluating as well as questioning solution-centric organizations, solution-centric businesses, because when people love their solutions more than your problems, it is time to reevaluate. Have a critical look at what they could be doing better and give them that feedback, because some will listen, some won't, and then you will know their true nature. Transformation, transformative innovation, both come from a deeper understanding of people's needs and wants, their intentions. So in the longer term, you must work on building and nurturing genuine connections. Try to avoid the superficial social media only connections. And most importantly, build at least one such transformative solution, transformative innovation-based solution yourself. Or maybe help someone else do that. Because the fact is, more than the problem, our inability to handle that problem disturbs us. Exponential growth, fast-moving economies, uncertainties, and ambiguities, these are major challenges for all of us. But when we look at the problems differently, everything changes. A better innovation becomes possible. Transformative innovation becomes possible, which is more reliable and more sustainable. So let's do it.